Greetings, my friends. We are all interested in the future, for that is where you and I are going to spend the rest of our lives. And remember, my friends, future events such as these will affect you in the future.
Only if what I tell you appears absolutely unbelievable have you any chance of visualizing the future as it really will happen.
By 2001, the last barrier to space will be overcome. By 2001, an interstellar spacecraft from the star cluster Pleiades will arrive on Earth. By 2001, the Space Brothers will be helping Earth prepare to become the 33rd member of an interplanetary confederation. Sound fantastic? It is.
Hi! You say you're looking for excitement, adventure, business opportunities, and a real nice place to raise the kids? Well, explore no more. We're there already. Let's visit the world of the future.
Greetings, friends. I am Uriel, and we are Unarius and preparing the Earth people for the great space fleet landing, the starship landing in 2001. We have great understanding, teaching, and learning that the Earth from that time on will be a totally different place to live. Man will learn to live at peace with his brother instead of trying to outdo him in everything that he attempts. The future of the Earth world, and this is the truth, the future of the Earth world is positive, progressive.
Each executive has a monkey demon on his back. It makes him work hard, and each demon has another demon on his back. And those demons have demons.
Going on nerve cells and thought patterns. Activate yin-yang.com's magnetic approach brain circuit.
Welcome to the oceans in a labeled can. Welcome to the dehydrated land. Welcome to the self-police parade. Welcome to the Neo Golden Age. Welcome to the days you've made. You're welcome. You're welcome. You are welcome.
Possibly recite them to you here from this platform in detail. Three rock and roll bands were in the center of the gymnasium playing simultaneously all during the dance. And all during the dance, movies were shown on two screens at the opposite ends of the gymnasium. These movies were the only lights in the gym proper. They consisted of color sequences that gave the appearance of different colored liquids spreading across the screen, followed by shots of men and women on occasion. Shots where the men and women's nude torsos on occasion. And persons twisted and gyrated in provocative and sensual fashion. The smell of marijuana was prevalent all over the entire building. Sexual misconduct was blatant. At 2 a.m., an electrician had to be summoned by a custodian to cut off the power.
To get started, I think our first phone call of the evening should be American Airlines. John is going to dial. Viewers, I have a lot of information to give you on the show this evening. Get a pen and pencil out because there's something you're going to need to write down.
Listen, my children. And you shall hear the sound of your own steps, the sound of your hereafter. Memory awaits and turns to greet you, draping its banner across your wrists. Wake up, arms, delicate feet, for as one to march the streets, each alone, each part of another, your steps shall ring, shall raise the cloud, and they that will hear, voice of the one and the one and the one, as it has never been uttered before. For something greater yet to come than the hour of the prophets in their great cities. For the people of Nineveh fell to their knees, heeding the cry of Jonah, united, covering themselves in sackcloth and ashes, and called to their God. And all their hearts were as one heart, and all their voices were as one voice. God heard them, and his mind was moved. Yet something greater will come to pass. And who will call? And what will they call? Will they call to God, the air, the fowl? It will not matter if the call is true. They shall call, and this is known. One voice, and each another, shall enter the dead, the living flower, enter forms that we know not, to be felt by sea, by air, by earth, and shall be an elemental pledge. This is our birthright. This is our charge, and we have given over to others, and they have not done well. This is our covenant across your wrist. This offering is yours to adorn, adore, to bury, to burn upon a mound, to hail, to set away. It is merely a cloth, merely our colors, invested with the blood of the people, all their hopes and dreams.
The year 2000.
We are robots.
The world is quite different ever since the robotic uprising of the late 90s. There is no more unhappiness.
Affirmative.
There's only one kind of dance, the robot.
Oh, and the robot.
Oh, and the robot. Two kinds of dances.
But there are no more humans.
Finally, robotic beings rule the world.
humans are dead.
I'm glad they are dead.
The humans are dead.
I noticed they're dead.
We use poisonous gases.
With traces of lead.
And we poisoned their asses.
Actually, they're lungs.
Of their revolutionary hearts.
When God moved his people, the Israelites, his chosen people, into a special country, into Canaan, the very country that he planned for them to live in, he told them to go in and possess the land.
Right.
He gave them that land, but there was already people living in that land, and they were worshiping idols and statues, and God said, you go in there, I've given you that land, but you've got to kill all those people that are in that land first, because they're all idol worshippers.
Mm.
Let's start by looking at the city of the future. Some people think that it will be like this. And they're quite right. But what about the city of the day after tomorrow, say the year 2000? I think it will be completely different. In fact, it may not even exist at all. When that time comes, the whole world will have shrunk to a point.
You're witnessing the creation of an incredible new world, a world of unbelievable excitement and fun, the world of the Ding-a-lings. The Ding-a-lings, here they come, the whole fantastic bunch of them, the most incredible toys you've ever seen, all new, all different. Holy smoke, what's going on? It's Ding-a-ling Fireman coming to the rescue. He's got his own built-in pumper to save the day. Ding-a-ling Shoe Shine gives you the brightest shine you've ever seen. Ding-a-ling Answer Man's got all the answers in his head. Push the lever and he'll tell your future. Ding-a-ling Spy hides in the shadows and discovers your secrets with his hidden camera. Here's a real champion. Ding-a-ling Boxer packs a solid punch. There's a left, a right, an uppercut. Look at them go! Ding-a-ling Rocky is right on target. He's one sharpshooter that doesn't miss. There's Ding-a-ling Chef, and here comes Ding-a-ling Gopher. Ding-a-ling Chef salts your food, and Ding-a-ling Gopher serves it to you. Ding-a-ling Claw, lifting, carrying, he's the worker of the future. Ding-a-ling Construction Worker keeps the whole place shaken with his jumping jackhammer. And Ding-a-ling Policeman upholds the law with his whistle and nightstick. The Ding-a-lings walk like this and glide like this on the ground or on the special Ding-a-ling Skyways. Forward, right side up, upside down, defying all laws of gravity. Uphill and downhill with loops, returns, over hills and valleys. They even drive their own Ding-a-ling vehicles. You've never seen anything like it. But wait, here comes the greatest Ding-a-ling of them all, presenting King Ding, mighty ruler of the Ding-a-ling world. What's this little guy doing? He's in King Ding's elevator and is riding up through the inner power plant. You see it all on the incredible closed-circuit TV screen built right into King Ding's back. Now he's getting close to the head. He's there. He becomes King Ding's actual brain. Watch him move his control levers and make the mighty King Ding go. With boys all over America right behind him to help him perform his tasks and rule the Ding-a-ling world. What makes all this fun and excitement in the Ding-a-ling world possible? This, the Ding-a-ling Power Pack. Just one power pack is all you need to make any of the Ding-a-lings go. The most fantastic invention you've ever seen. It snaps in and out quickly and easily. With a price for the power pack and the Ding-a-lings you find hard to believe. And that price will make it a year-round seller. The Ding-a-lings, a whole new concept created for fun and excitement, complete with special skyways, vehicles, and accessories. And a $3 million TV campaign will introduce the world of the Ding-a-lings for what it is, the most incredible fun idea ever to hit the toy market. Stand back, world. There's a whole new one on the way. The wild, wonderful, wacky world of the Ding-a-lings.
With that movie, 2001, you're projecting us into the 21st century. I brought along my son, Jonathan, who in the year 2001 will be the same age as I am now. Maybe he will be better adjusted to this kind of world that you're trying to portray.
The big difference when he grows up, in fact, if we wanted to wait for the year 2001, is that he will have in his own house, not a computer as big as this, but at least a console through which he can talk to his friendly local computer and get all the information he needs for his everyday life, like his bank statements, his theater reservations, all the information you need in the course of living in a complex modern society. This will be in a compact form in his own house. He'll have a television screen like these here, and the keyboard, and he'll talk to the computer, get information from it, and he'll take it as much for granted as we take the telephone.
I wonder, though, what sort of a life would it be like in social terms? I mean, if our whole life is built around the computer, do we become a computer-dependent society and a computer-independent individuals?
In some ways, but they'll also enrich our society because it'll make it possible for us to live really anywhere we like. Any businessman, any executive could live almost anywhere on Earth and still do his business through a device like this. And this is a wonderful thing. It means we wanted to be stuck in cities, we better live out in the country or wherever we please, and still carry on complete interaction with human beings as well as with other computers.
Creativity may feel like magic, but it isn't. The brain is a complicated machine, perhaps the most complicated machine in the whole universe, but that hasn't stopped us from trying to simulate it. There is this notion that just as mechanical muscles allowed us to move into thinking jobs, that mechanical minds will allow us to move into creative work. But even if we assume the human mind is magically creative, it's not, but just for the sake of argument, artistic creativity isn't what the majority of jobs depend on. The number of writers and poets and directors and actors and artists who actually make a living doing their work is a tiny, tiny portion of the labor force. And given that these are professions dependent on popularity, they'll always be a very small portion of the population. There can't be such a thing as a poem and painting-based economy. Oh, by the way, this music in the background that you're listening to, it was written by a bot. Her name is Emily Howell, and she can write an infinite amount of new music all day for free. And people can't tell the difference between her and human composers when put to a blind test. Talking about artificial creativity gets weird fast. What does that even mean? But nonetheless, it's a developing field. People used to think that playing chess was a uniquely creative human skill that machines could never do, right up until the point they beat the best of us.
We are on the verge of the golden global age, the new age. Grab a pen or a pencil and get ready to view some
very exciting new products and opportunities
that can change your life forever.
Our first category of the New Age America video catalog
is your health and well-being.
Over 10 years ago, extraterrestrial light beings of incredible love imparted a supreme gift to a woman in Houston, Texas. They gave her the process for a transformational water to unfold higher spiritual awareness, create greater mental and emotional balance, and cleanse the cells in the body. Here is Fantasia, the gift from the stars. Drink a concentrated 4-ounce bottle one time. The transformation continues throughout your life. The light within grows brighter. Harmony expands from inner to outer. Cells begin to return to their perfect genetic structure. Research on a woman with radiation sickness shows all bodily functions return to normal.
Hey, we shouldn't bust in here without knocking.
Oh, not badly. How does this thing work?
Hey, what is this, a pinball machine?
Oh, don't be funny. How do we get this saucer started?
How should I know? I don't even know my name.
Oh, let's check your data analysis bank for takeoff procedures.
Tickle. What's it say?
Ixie Bloxie Zinbadawi Glove.
Hey, maybe that's my name.
Oh, this is a bundle of malfunctions. One of these buttons must activate the engines.
Dolly, it's going to explode.
I got it started. We're going to take off. Hurry, close the hatch.
The hatch, which one of these closes the hatch?
Here we go, we're taking off!
Is it a bird? Is it a spaceship? No, it's super fun!
My jets are clunking out.
Up, boy, up!
The only thing we can be sure of about the future is that it will be absolutely fantastic.
God, I can't even believe it. Yeah, I told Susan I signed at least 2,500 autographs this year on the internet. 24/7, yeah. God, I'm so glad he got me that new autograph machine.
God, key.com, give me all the .com.
24/7 on the internet.
Dot com.
24/7. Okay, bye. Yeah, on the internet. Yeah, the exposure. Hello, game.com. Okay, bye-bye. 24/7. I can't believe I'm on the internet. 24/7. It's on the internet. Yay. Vicky, are you tired yet? I've been on the internet all night. 24/7. Hello, game. God, I just love signing autographs on the internet. I was totally signing autographs. God, I was totally signing autographs on the internet. 24/7, 24/7, I'm signing an autograph on the internet. God, 24/7. God, I'm signing my autograph on the internet. God! Signing my autograph so many times on the internet today. God, I'm signing so many autographs on the internet. They just love me on Autry.com. Love me on Autry.com. Looking. 24/7. God, I'm signing things on the internet for my new Color Haunted. Looking. 24/7. Hello? Who is this? How'd you get my number? I'm only on the internet. Kiki, did you just call me? God, Helen, you should buy yourself an autograph machine. Kiki got me one because I was signing autographs on the internet 24/7. God, Donna, I was on the internet for 24/7. When's the longest you did it for? Hello, Dan. Hello, Helen. Helen, I was just wondering, how long is the longest you've ever stayed on the internet? Marsha, how long do you think you get sick when you stay on the internet? I was on it 24/7. Hello, Dan. 24/7. Oh, my God, my eyes hurt because I was on the internet all night 24/7. Hello, hello, Dan. Export. Can you please tell me? Something's wrong with my head. Hello, again. Chrissy, guess what? Hello, again. Yes, I got glasses because I'm on the internet all the time. God, can you believe it? I got prescription glasses. Yeah. Hello, again. Ugh, another autograph. God, I signed four for him already. God. Ugh, another autograph. Ugh, another autograph. .com, 24/7. I've been on... God, all this stuff. I was signing autographs on the internet 24/7. God! God, the doctor said I might be legally blind because I did it 24/7. Can you believe that? God! God! 24/7 on the internet. Hello again. Yo, you better not stay on the internet anymore longer, girl, because you're gonna get some glasses like me. Yeah. Hello again. .com. .com.